Hello, my name is Xander and welcome to the Python Excel series. In this first tutorial of this series, we take a look at Pandas module read Excel function, which reads the Excel sheet data into a DataFrame object. Let me quickly take you through what's going to be covered in this tutorial. So first of all, we'll take a look at the process of actually getting an Excel file into a DataFrame. Once we've done that, we can discuss converting that data into different data structures and then having a look at some of the other parameter values of the readExcel function. So we know how to work with the readExcel function to meet our needs. At that point, we're focusing really on utilizing DataFrames, Panda DataFrames. So we go ahead and inspect the new data that's been moved into our DataFrame and then go ahead and select and extract data from the DataFrame. We finish up with just looking at how to select multiple individual sheets because most of the time Excel, we're utilizing multiple sheets. If you have just started thinking about or needing to utilize Python with Excel, it's worth directing you straight away to the openpyxl, which we will be installing and what Pandas will be utilizing here in this tutorial. So this is a Python library, which is probably one of the most popular libraries to work with Python and Excel. And as we go through the series, we will dip in and out of Pandas and working directly with openpyxl. If you are completely new to Python, there is a little bit of setup here I want to take you through. If you are already familiar with Python and virtual machines, just skip ahead to the next section in the video timeline. All right, so let's go ahead and just make a new folder. I've made a folder on my desktop. I'm going to select Open Folder and open that folder. I've gone ahead and opened this folder, which was on my desktop, and I've made this new file called example.py, which I'll be utilizing throughout this tutorial. So because I'm going to be installing some other modules, some libraries, I'm going to create a virtual machine, a virtual environment. So I just drag this up here and I'm going to type in py for py. So I'm assuming you've got Python installed. And then we're going to use the m flag to then install or create a new virtual environment folder called vemv. So this virtual environment just allows me to create a new environment to work within. So that when I install new modules, new libraries, it means it doesn't update the main Python installation on my computer. It just works within this small virtual environment here. So now I've done that, let's just go ahead and activate this. So vent script activate. So I can tell it's activated because it has the word vent here. So I've activated, now I'm working in my virtual environment. So in order for us to work with Pandas, we're going to need to install Pandas. So let's go ahead and pip install Pandas. Now, if you're working on a computer at work, it might be that this might be blocked in your firewall. You might not be able to install Pandas, for example. So if it does come up with an error, that might be the case. So you can see we've installed that pip install Pandas. There we go. Right, so Pandas is installed, so we can now go ahead and import Pandas as PD. Pandas relies on some other tools that's needed, and this is where we're going to need to pip install the openpyxl library. So let's go ahead and just copy that, and then go ahead and also install that. And there we go, so we're now ready to start. So we're going to need some data. So I've got two files here, which you'll find in the code repository. There's a link in the video description to the GitHub repository. There you'll find all of these examples as well as this data. So this is just a simple set of books. Let's see if I can open this up. Okay, so we've got two sheets here, books and books underscore two. You can see that we've got a number of different titles here, headings. And then we've got 10 books here. And four books here. Right. So let's go ahead and import our file and convert this into a data frame. So let's go ahead and import books.xlsx. And we also do the same for CSVs, just so you can see the fact that it's not just Excel file sheets that we can work with. There are other file types too. And we go ahead and convert that. So PD from Pandas, read Excel. So we use the read Excel function from Pandas. And then we pass in the Excel file in this case. And then we go ahead and create a new function here called DFCSV. Again, this time using read CSV to read in the CSV file. So that's how we're going to get this started, by importing in our book. So let's go ahead now and create our data frame from these files. So first of all, the Excel file. So that's the books.xlsx. And then we just do the same thing. You might already be familiar with this with CSV files. So we do the same thing again there. And then we go ahead and now create a new variable df. And then we use pandas and then the panda function read Excel. And then we pass in the first parameter, which is going to be the actual file that we want to then convert that data into a data frame. So we can do the same thing again here for the CSV file. So we can now access this data straight away by referring to DF or DF CSV. So I'm just going to remove this because this isn't going to feature in the rest of the tutorial. Right, so let's just go ahead and let's just print this out. So DF, for example. Now we need to run this. So let's go ahead and run this file. So you can see the output here is 10 rows. You can see we've selected all the data, all the headings, all the data is there, and we're outputting the 10 rows from our books.xlsx. So from this point, we can now start manipulating, if we like, or selecting different parts of this data from our data frame. So it might be that you prefer to utilize this data, this new data, as a dictionary, or you might want to utilize it as CSV, or potentially convert it to JSON. So that's easily done at this point. So we can use, again, DF to DIC, to CSV, or to JSON. So we can convert that data frame into these different data structures, and then we can go ahead and utilize it however we want from there. So let me just go ahead and print out, for example, the dictionary. So we just go ahead and run that. So we now have a new dictionary of that dictionary of the data that's been passed in from the Excel file. If you take a look at the video description, there is a link there that will take you to a GitHub repository. All the code that's in this tutorial will be there for you to have a look at, as well as some reading resources, and one of them being the Pandas Read Excel Function API reference documentation. So here you can take a look at all the different parameters that you can pass in to the function, which may come in use for your particular use case. So we can see here that the read Excel takes in essentially the file. That's the first parameter, but we can add additional parameters here. So there's multiple parameters we can add. So I will be talking a little bit further about the sheet name, because you've probably already seen from the Excel file that we looked at, there were two sheets. So we want to work with different sheets potentially. Now notice that earlier we printed, let me just get rid of some of this. We printed out the data frame, and what we saw originally was the data from the first sheet only. So we do have two sheets in our XLS file, but it's only showing the first sheet here. So the question being, well, how do I access other sheets? We'll look at that at the end of this tutorial, but that is just one parameter, just to give you an idea of what we can pass in. So here, for example, I could select the sheet by the actual index. So the first sheet in your Excel file will be sheet 0, the next one 1, and so on. Or else I can go ahead and just select by the name of the sheet. Okay, so that's a possibility there, or one of the parameters that we can utilize. So second to that is we can also, for example, specify what column we want to use. So use cols equals. And then we go ahead and just select the column that we want to actually utilize. So now, for example, if I print this out again, I've now only selected the title heading or the title column. Of course, I can go ahead and expand that if I wanted to also include multiple columns. Let's just give that a go. So now I've returned the title and authors. So now we have a better idea of how to get our data from our Excel file into a data frame. Let's just go ahead and think about inspecting this data frame. So far, we've seen that we can utilize or just call a df function, which is going to then show us all the data within our data frame from our Excel sheet. So that can be a little bit overwhelming, if we've got a lot of data. So obviously we can go ahead and start manipulating this. So for example, we can utilize head, which will allow us to select the top five or top 10 or the first, 20 items or rows in our data. So let's go ahead and have a look at that. So obviously I don't have 20. So let's just go ahead and just select the first two. There we go. So we just select the first two rows. You can see that we've got 12 columns of this data. So that gives us an idea there. So we can do the same thing again if we just wanted to see the last two items or the last 10 items by utilizing tail. So let's go ahead and have a look at the columns. So that's going to give us a list of all the columns here. And then finally, we can have a look at the data types. So now we have a better idea of what data we have or what data we're working with. Let's now have a look at some of the techniques to select parts of the data or some of the data from our data frame. There are various ways of selecting data from our data frame. For example, we can directly from our variable df here, we can then select, for example, the headings that we want to display. So we'll have a look at that first, and then we're moving to at. So here we can select or access a single value at a time, for example, or move into and utilize lock, which can select multiple rows and or columns. I have left a link in the GitHub repository, which will take you to a resource where you can read through this in more detail. Let's go ahead and select some data. So we're going to print this out, df. So let's just select, for example, the heading title. So we just want to display this column. Let's go ahead and just print that out. Okay, so here we have the title column. Now we can go ahead and select more columns. But if we do this, we're going to need double square brackets. So let's go ahead and do that. Authors. So now we've selected multiple columns. And then just thinking about the tools that we learned earlier, we can then go ahead, for example, maybe we just want to display a certain amount. So let's just go for 5. So that will return the top 5 items from our data frame here. If we wanted to be a little bit more specific and select a specific piece of data or maybe a specific row from our data frame here, we can utilize this index here. So notice this index starts from 0. So we could say that this row here is referred to index 0, for example. So what we can do now is we can utilize at, and let's go ahead and select that. So position 0 or row 0. And let's go ahead and also just output the title. And there we go. So we've outputted just the title. So that was the first item in our data frame here. If we wanted to, for example, select a range of data, Well, maybe we might want to choose lock. So df lock. And this time we might want to select a range. So we select a slice, so 0.3, for example. And then in addition to that, we may also want to select multiple columns. So let's try that out. Authors. So we'll print that. And there we go. So we've now got our slice. And we've now also selected title and authors. So now we can see the general principles of selecting data from our data frame. Of course, like we alluded to earlier, our Excel file may have multiple sheets. So we may want to work with these multiple sheets individually. In a later tutorial, we'll have a look at merging data from multiple sheets. But let's just see how we can work with initially multiple sheets that we might have within our Excel file. We can select what sheet we want to work with by passing in the sheet name. So that can be, for example, by index or the actual sheet name. So what we're referring to here by index, for example, is if I go into my Excel sheets here, we can see that we have two sheets. So this will be referenced as sheet 0, this would be sheet 1, and so on and so on. Alternatively, we can just use the name of the sheet. Let's try and access the second sheet. So that would be sheet name 1. And now let's go ahead and select 1. And let's go ahead and now print out that. So let's just double check. So when we go back here, we've got Hitchhikers to Bill's book. And you can see that that is the case here. So we asked, and we have now selected working with this sheet 1. Now let's go ahead, and I think that was called books underscore 2. So if we do that now, you can see that that isn't going to work. So now, of course, we can just specify the name here. So this is going to be books 2. So that's the data we want to work with. And there we go. So we might want to be working with multiple sheets. So let's go ahead, for example, and we can just use the index of the sheet and so on, or we could just use the names. So there we can just specify the sheets we want to use and then select the sheet we want to use. And then in this case, just output some simple data. So for example, if we wanted to select all the sheets, we could just place none here, for example. And then from here, this is still going to work absolutely fine. Or for example, we want to get the data from the first sheet. So we just use the index reference here, which isn't going to work. So that won't work with the reference. So we could do that with 1. But if we were, for example, going to utilize a name, which was just books, that's the name of the first sheet, books. And there we go. So hopefully that gives you a general or initial feel of selecting multiple sheets. So I do hope there's some value there for you. And don't forget, there is a GitHub repository, and use that repository to start making some notes or kind of a quick guide for yourself so that you can start to remember some of these different tools. Now, this type of tutorial is bound to get some thumbs down simply because there's just so much more to tell you. And I've just tried to kind of skim the fat to get to that kind of initial starting point. And hopefully I've given you a good grounding of initial information, which will help you now move forward in this area. This tutorial will act as a starting point for many of the other tutorials that we feature in this tutorial series. So I had that in mind also when I built this tutorial. I didn't want to show you too much so that we can progress further in other tutorials. So thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you stay tuned to watch the other tutorials in this series. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.